old school shit. Like it like that.
So right, we on?
We on, we rolling, nigga. Talk about it. What just took place, my man?
So we down here in Philly, kid, right? That what they call a producer circle, you know what I'm saying? And they asked what's the creative process or some shit? They say some shit about the creative process, they asked the motherfuckers to come up there. So I go up there, you know.
Share.
Come on.
Yeah. So
what is
your name?
My name is Quincy. Hi, everybody. Hey. And I do the ASI social show, and I can reach you.
Oh, God.
Yeah. With our creative process, what we do is get really wasted. And then, no, you know, you sit and...
Since we're gonna hold that thought.
I'm a little nervous and shit. Then, as soon as they asked what was up my creative process, I said, well, we get wasted, and boom, they cut me right the fuck off. Right the fuck off. All these motherfuckers talking this corny ass bullshit.
You gonna see the footage of this shit too.
Yo, well, I'm gonna cut all of them the fuck out, we gonna just make our own shit.
How about that?
You know what I'm saying? But, they cut me right off. Everybody else talking for like 5 fucking minutes talking all this old bullshit, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, we do community shit, but we doing this shit for the average motherfucker, not this bullshit. You know what I'm saying? Fucking radio control cars, you fucking weirdo.
Speaking of which, you know what I'm saying? My man had the balls to jump up there in a room full of them motherfuckers. Pretentious motherfuckers, you so passionate. So much vigor about what they're doing. Ain't nobody say nothing about no fucking bread. Everybody fraud in there. All this, that's what our show is about. You know what I'm saying? Excuse me, hold on, I'm gonna talk when the bull. Throw this bulldozer real fast. He fucked my interview. All right, woo! Crack that shit, nigga! Drag it! Oh, God. Okay. Is that shit? Before I was rudely interrupted by the city motherfucking workers trying to
because you are.
As you just getting cut off left and right, man. Goddamn, can nigga get a break? All these motherfucking politically correct motherfuckers in there gotta say the right thing and all this. Our show is about expression. If you wanna curse, you can curse. You wanna wild, you can wild. You can be yourself, the self that you are when you amongst your friends and you in the bar drinking. That's what the anti-social show is about. They didn't get a chance to say that, so we gonna make our own show about it and intertwine it.
They put it on their fucking network.
Put it on their network.
But that's what the fuck you do.
Never be afraid to show your ass. That's to roll the teenage years.
Okay,
with the glasses on.
Thank you, Gina. So wonderful. Thank you.
Fire Marshal Bill. Stephen Urkel. That nigga's a weirdo. Oh, hey. Oh, man, she's a freak. You gotta do behind the scenes production. Anti-social show is in the room. Be a fly on the wall. Look at all these strong ass conversations. Everybody talking like they know each other and they so in love with each other. That's a big strong ass conversation. This is what goes on. This is what you got to do to make it. You know what I'm saying? We all sit around a bunch of motherfuckers and talk about the bullshit you don't really want to talk about. Everybody talking about everything but the money. Who the fuck in here is talking about the money right now? Which one? Gold medal Olympic winner Serena Williams. tennis anymore?
That's Serena Williams.
Did you turn the camera on her? Put it on her so they...
It's my name, Clifford Allen, the fucking belligerent, right, nigga?
Twerking,
bouncing, young pop, champagne, they know the face and they know the name.
Drop that pussy, bitch. What you twerking, bounce, work, 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 bounce, work, work, work. What you twerking, bounce, work, 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 bounce.
That's gonna be a crazy show. That's my homie Tiffany. We been out doing good peoples. You fly on this shit, on this bullshit, this pretentious. Fraudulent. Bullshit. So many phonies. Not enough balonies. I need a sandwich. Because I'm hungry. And so is she.
Watch out for the big girl. Watch out. Big girl, move over. Big girl should have her own show. She speaks very well. She like the goose from motherfucking Good Times. She would fuck somebody up, man. But. Body slams on deck. Double cheeseburgers on deck.
It might be 2 years before I even look at a drink.
Oh, hey, man, I love
some,
you.
You know, something smoke or some rib or some crack or anything. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
and I go through that on a weekly basis.
I was a fiend before I became a teen. I melted microphones instead of cones of ice cream. Music orientated, so when hip-hop was originated, fitted like pieces of puzzle, complicated. Cause I grab the mic and try to say yes, y'all. They try to take it and say that I'm too small. Cool, cause I don't get upset. I kick a hole in the speaker, pull a plug, then I jet back to the lab without a mic to grab. So then I add all the rhymes I had, one after the other one. Then I make another one to diss the opposite, then ask if the brother's done. I get a craving like I fiend for nicotine, but I don't need a cigarette, know what I mean?
Homie the clown, homie the clown. Those are nice.
So how are you? You're both gentlemen and a scholar. Introduce yourself.
Hello, my name is Michael Knight, and I am the producer of Dialed In RC.
Tell us about it.
Dialed In RC is the RC speed channel for radio-controlled racing.
Man, fucking radio-controlled cars, you fucking weirdo.
Radio-controlled racing is an international sport.
Fucking radio-controlled cars, you fucking weirdo.
Notified me about Philly Cam, and after coming down to Philly Cam, I had been here for about maybe 8 months just volunteering. Then I signed up as a member, and then I began to produce my own program.
Fucking radio control cars, you fucking weirdo!
And I've produced over 25 episodes at this point. And Philly Cam, without Philly Cam, I would not be able to get the word out. And as far as branding, as I have here on my shirt, branding is vital to the growth of any business. And I use all of the mediums. And not only do I use the mediums, Facebook, YouTube, and the internet, but I also have an internet channel. I have my own television channel, and I use that as well. And I also, it's vital to get out into the community. I travel from state to state to promote what I'm trying to do, which is the vision, is to take a hobby, which is radio control racing, from a hobby, which is introverted, to an extroversion, which is bringing it out to the mass media and creating an extreme game sport.
Fucking radio control cars, you fucking weirdo!
And so that's the goal, and at the same time, giving children an opportunity on alternative to gangs, violence, promiscuity, and all of these things that confront the children today, bring them out of the city, bring them into the rural areas, and give them, you know, an opportunity to excel in automotive, electronics, and things of that nature, because all of that comes into play.
How interesting. Lynn?
Fucking radio control cars, you fucking weirdo!
One other thing I was curious about, has the access to these audiences throughout the globe now impacted or influenced your product in terms of how you incorporate things you may not have thought about to do in the product before you knew? Like, say if you were Czechoslovakia or somewhere, I don't know, how you've changed your product in a sentence or two.
Okay. Well, I changed my product because people wanted more than just, you know, viewing it. They wanted to hold it in their hands.
Fucking weirdo, 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 weirdo.
Belligerents, Clifford Allen, right?
And I'm the ignorant Quincy T. Johnson, and we are drunk as shit.
The blue.
Oh! That don't look tasty.
The technical term is
vagina.
It's all right while I'm looking over your shoulder, watching the whole line. You hate when it's a ball, right? Ladies, this ain't handball. Nigga,
he's all tight, so I call Mike.
In the morning when it's all bright, eggs over easy. Oh yeah, my shit tight when I open my eyes. While I'm eating, getting dressed up, this ain't your pad. I left some money on the dresser, find you a cab. No more shivering, I pay.
Pretty sure you get that. You tell us action and then, you know.
All right, well, what we're going to do is you're actually going to talk to me over here. Okay.
Oh, so we ain't looking at the camera.
No, you're looking at me.
Okay. Are we rolling?
Are we rolling?
What?
Are we on?
Yeah, we're rolling.
All right, I got to get on my, this is my good side.
Right. Right.
This is my good side.
This is my bad side, too. But I don't got a good side, but I'm just accommodating this gentleman.
All
right. We're over here.
So, gentlemen.
Hi.
Who?
Can you please tell me a little bit about your show?
I'm gonna let my co-host speak first. First, introduce yourself to the people.
Yes, I'm Quincy Johnson. Hi. Hi, Gretchen. How are you? We are the Anti-Social Show. I am the Ignorance.
And I be the Belligerence, Clifford Allen Wright.
And our show is a blend of social issues, humor and satire, shaken and stirred,
unconventionally,
and that's what it is.
Into a big cocktail.
Into an awful, big, nasty
balls on cocktail, but yes, into a big cocktail. You know, drink responsibly.
Yes,
you know.
Okay, so why public access? Why bring the Anti-Social Show?
Why not? Is a better question. Why not? It's accessible, public access. We are the public. It's our first line of being able to inform the people what we're trying to create. First line of the, like, you know, defense for us.
And our show being on public access allows us to express ourselves in the way that you know, kind of freely, you know. And our show does have a message. It's wrapped around a whole bunch of crap, but there are messages in each show. So,
gotta pay attention.
Yeah, you gotta pay attention.
You might miss it. And it's a very brief message.
I know how difficult it is to pay attention when you're watching the train wreck, but you gotta keep your eyes on it because sometimes dead bodies fall out the train.
So what's the goal of your show?
Goal of our show. That's a good question.
Well, the goal of the show, as far as I'm concerned, is worldwide, you know, exposure, global. I'm talking, you know, nationwide, and then you know, what have you. I'm gonna go into planetary. I'm gonna go intergalactic. I wanna take this thing out of space if possible. You know, for real, for real. I want everybody to know what the Anti-Social is, Anti-Social Show is, because I believe it, I live it, and it's not. You hear Anti-Social, and people sometimes think that it means you don't like to talk to people. But if you look at the definition of it, you look a little further, it also means that you're going against the normal things that society stipulates. Not to say that those normal things aren't good and you can't achieve success, but there's other avenues that you can take. There's other forms of expression. And, you know, I'm an adult and I'm not going to act like I've never cursed before. You know, I have. And sometimes people, they have to curb their enthusiasm when they're around a certain sect of people. Our show is the forum where you don't have to curb your enthusiasm. You can say whatever you want to say and not be judged for it. It's nothing terrible.
And also, with our show, one of the goals is to talk to people. And talk to people that people normally wouldn't talk to. We talk to crackheads. We talk to bums. We talk to drunks because they have a story too.
We all got around to that.
And we also talk to successful people who do film and do video and you know, things of that sort. You know, we interview.
Oh, hold on. I'm going to say this to the camera.
Catchphrase.
We talk to anybody because everybody is somebody.
No one's excluded. Everybody's welcome. The door is always open. You know, it's like 7-Eleven. You know, you even open on Christmas, New Year's, we open.
And in turn, isn't that what public access is all about?
Absolutely.
Public access is all about you, the viewer, getting access to the public, and the public getting access to the community. See how I broke that down? See, sometimes I can get serious. I'm sorry, I'm supposed to be talking
about that. That's okay. So I asked this question to everybody, and I don't know if you guys are going to be able to do it, but here's the challenge. If you could describe Philly Cam in one word, what would it be?
Resource. That's a good word.
Fun. You see how my vocabulary skills just came to the forefront. Fun. It's a nice place, man.
Yeah, it's a good place to be.
You know, and I would suggest, you know, if I could, because we don't really pump Philly Cam like we should on our show as much as we should.
Because we really appreciate it.
We really do. And like, you know, for all you people out there, you know, who happen to get to see this, like, there's other avenues for you to travel, and Philly Cam is a great place for you if you're interested in entertainment and media and just connecting with people, this, that, and the third. This is a great place for you to get your start, get your feet wet, you know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely do what you want to do. You have to, if you have a dream or you have a vision.
Okay, doctor.
No, seriously, because a lot of people don't do this. A lot of people don't, because a lot of people waste time and all that type of stuff. I got to hurry up and
wrap it up.
Just do it.
You got an idea. See the message in the bull crap?
Do it.
That was a message.
Do it.
Wrap it up.
Don't
talk too much.
Do it. Do it.
No, I swear the tape is running out.
It's all good. All you got to do is they cut us off in there. They cut us off on there.
Do a promo. Say, watch your show. Say who you are and when your show is.
This is the anti-social show.
I'm the ignorance. Hold on. Start it all over. Hurry up.
This is the anti-social show.
I'm the ignorance.
I'm the belligerence. Tuesdays, 11 o'clock p.m. on
Philly Cam. 66 Comcast.
Verizon 29.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. That was fun.
Perfect. It just ran out.
Maybach music.
And they stay down, and they stay down, and they stay down. Up, down, up, down, up, down. Cause all I do is win,
win,
win, win.
And if you going in, put them hands in the air, let them say that.
Maybach music.
I remember when Maybach music was a dream. We started in the basement. I love you too. We started in the basement, but this Tuesday, we have Philadelphia's own Meek Mill album in stores.
Maybach music.
It's by far the most anticipated album of this year. So with that on my mind and in front of a beautiful crowd, it's only one record that can describe how I feel.
Care about his money in the city that I'm from. I'ma sip until I feel it, I'ma sip until it's done. I don't really give a f**k in my excuses that I'm young. And I'm only getting up with somebody shut a tongue.
Come on, I get him up, bounce, 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 baby. Come on, bounce, 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 b
City that I'm from, I'ma sip until I feel it, I'ma smoke until it's done. I don't really
put
give
your hands
a
out right
my
now.
Excuses that I'm young.
Let's go,
and I'm old.
Put him up,
and
let's go, up. Put him up, put him up.
I'm on
Bill,
right there. I turned around as I was looking at this fine white woman, and I saw Rosé behind me, and I said, Rosé!
They don't know how to get in suicide doors, man. You know what I'm saying? This is what's going on. Oh my God, I'm about to get hurt. There's a bunch of children out here. They about to whirl us. You know what I'm saying? It's a storm. Yeah, it's gonna be on YouTube. It's gonna be on YouTube. Look, she's gonna be the star, future star, gang sign. I do a TV show, young boy. Yeah, I'm gonna make sure y'all get out there and kick it. This is what's going on. We in the hood. You know what I'm saying? They wild as hell. I don't know what's going on out here. But this little nigga, he busting off going crazy. You ain't with them? Yeah, you ain't about there like that light, man. Y'all be safe out here. Don't hurt nobody. Huh? I got you. Stay sharp. Hey, listen. Education is paramount. Read books. Stay in school. Do the right thing. Say no to drugs. Fight the power.
Wait, why are you doing this? How do you usually do
it? I do it, man. It's my job, man. I make things happen.